Marshall wrote 1 century ago, so that the most precious part of the human capital depends on intergenerational transmission of attitudes and values within the family. And the role of mothers is key. So maybe I'm wrong, but my suspicion is that alone investing a lot of money in education, and it could also be a debate because, I mean, every society is free to do its choices about curricula. However, correcting the curricula, I don't think will be enough, will not be sufficient to achieve those high level of labor productivity and skills for working in the next generation. Because otherwise, people, yes, will learn more math and sciences until they are in school. They will pass the exams knowing more. Maybe they will be, they will reach a higher rank in the international test. But then the notions will disappear once they will leave school. And they will return to, say, rent-seeking habits or passive habits instead of embracing in a very active way the world of creation, the world of production, and eliminate some of them, and to use the money that has been devoted to those funds for this type of project. And the idea is, again, like I said before, that in this way you leave individuals, human beings, males and females, without any discrimination, without any preferential treatment of those who have the good relation with the guy who works at the ministry, the good relation with the guys who works at the bank and so on. You have a transparent support for everybody, and then you leave the individuals make the best out of it. Again, the individual is the agent who knows best what the given opportunities are worth for him, and should have the opportunity to make his choice. And this is best done, I think, by granting this fund at the beginning with the implicit contract that, well, citizen, here you have your opportunity, here you have your startup gift, make the best out of it, take your responsibility, and then please don't come to knock the door of the state for every possible help. Only in very serious cases we will help, but first of all you have to take your responsibility seriously and use the opportunities that society is granting you. Again, I think this is once again the basic point. It is very difficult for us, somebody who is not the directly interested person, to decide what is the best investment. So it is always easy to give an advice from outside. For instance, investment managers in bank have given plenty of advice how investors should use their money in the last month, but it was not their money, so they wasted their money. I think that there will be the world is a very diversified entity, and individuals are highly heterogeneous. There are plenty of different projects for everybody of us. And everybody should look for the best project for his own values and preferences. And society has to accomplish the task of giving everybody the opportunity to reach those tasks. And that's, I think, more than enough. I agree that it is not the only ingredient in order to have a successful society and a prospering economy. For instance, you need well-defined property rights. You have to have what the Germans call the Rechtsstaatlichkeit, and contracts have to be enforced. So there are many features that lacked in the example that you mentioned. So that's why I do not buy it. But some advice, some forms of cooperation, and some orientation, also by the government, should be part of the whole package. But my task was to indicate the new and not to repeat the good sense of the old.
Thank you.